in crazy times. And it is, I mean, literal prophecy is unfolding right in front of our eyes. And I've heard people say over and over, like, this kind of sentiment, and I've heard some things in response to it that I think is really important for us to remember. People kind of, it feels like everything is falling apart. But the reality is that we have to know is that really things are just starting to come together. It may seem like all around the world, everything around us is just falling apart. There's chaos, there's wars, and there's rumors of wars. But what we have to understand biblically is that, no, actually, things are just coming together. Things are transpiring. And so God does not want us to walk in fear and trepidation. He doesn't want us to be worried about anything. God wants us to be prepared for what's to come. Can I get an amen from somebody today? And so my challenge to us today is this right here. We need to learn the importance of a poured out life. I'm going to say it again, a poured out life. There's nothing better than a poured out life, just completely pouring our lives out to Jesus. Amen? Too many of us, and now I'm obviously not referring to anybody in this church or anybody watching online today. Too many of us live a life that's poured in. We do everything we can to pour into ourselves and fill ourselves up and just create as much margin as we can and just pour ourselves up and take and take and take. And what has happened in our Western culture and our Americanized church is what we have is a church full of takers. I'm not talking about you. Put a smile on your face. Good, smile. Good, smile. Smile. I get so many teachers got the ones who bought. That the idea to buy is the joke is not just a joke. I'll pour it all out, and I'm ready to meet my God. To the point where we understand it. And be ready for what God has next. I want them to see. Look, I'm not going to get it all right all the time. As a church, we're not going to get it all right all the time. But I'm going to tell you what. When I make a mistake, I'm going to make a mistake going forward for Jesus. If I miss it, I'm going to miss it moving forward for Jesus. I might not get it figured out all the time, all the way right, but I am going to live a poured out life for Jesus. And I'm just asking every one of you to come along with me, and let's pour out together for our wonderful Savior. Is anybody happy today or thankful today for their wonderful Savior Jesus? Come on. Listen, our hearts should be stirred and burdened for our Savior. Offering to God. And I want all of you to share that joy. You got to know today that, see, we think if we just take the right type of vacation, that's going to bring joy. Or if we just do this, that's going to bring joy. We do that and it's just going to bring joy. Or if we just change this situation, it's going to bring joy. But the reality is the only thing that brings true joy, I believe, it helps us tap into that third aspect of the kingdom. The kingdom of God is not about eating and drinking, but what is the kingdom's joy? It's a life poured out for Him in service to Him. Somebody say joy. Yes, you should rejoice, and I will share your joy. There's just so much in this passage, but so many of us miss it. Because when we get to the book of Leviticus, we start to go to sleep. Who's ever had a good nap by reading the word? When you get to you're like, oh yeah, cool, Joshua, Judges, oh, there's some cool stuff. But you get to Leviticus, and it's like, oh. And you hear, listen, if you ever have trouble sleeping, just open up your word to some of these books like Leviticus. It is a great book. But for some of you heathens that get bored with the Bible, not me. I mean, I'm so spiritual and grounded in my faith. I mean, it's just the word speak to me in my dreams. No, the truth is that the more you gain understanding, the more things speak to you from books like Leviticus. And you cannot live a poured out life is a risky life. That when we live,
you will inspire some people to give their lives to Christ, but you're also going to inspire some people to give their lives to Christ. Come on now. When you tell them for Jesus that you really support yourself, don't be fine on the hour. I'm just wondering. You're going to take a little longer today. When we start living for Jesus and pouring ourselves out, it is not safe. Christianity is not supposed to be a safe religion. It's not supposed to be a fixed relationship. Now, we're taking elements, but outside of that, we can't just call it to a deep and rich individual, except we're giving God for some rich people that I've never had. God is not calling to a comfortable place. In fact, one of the missions that God has given is to a comfortable and comforting place. The reality is that God does not call us to a comfortable place. Now, my wife and I, 5 years ago now, just simply do this. We decided that the Holy Spirit in us that we are meant to be made for God, and we have to explore the option of the textual areas that we can go into. And one of those things was not God. There are some options, there are some things that God is coming back to hear us if I want to connect you to the Lord. And I was like, no, I don't know about that. I'm not, okay, I don't know people, I've heard you all before.
People, old people, all people, stir them up and fill them up with the Holy Spirit and set them on fire for Him. That's why we're here today, folks. Not to just sit back and relax and just... checking the box of Sunday. We need to learn to live a poured out life. And here's what I also believe. I don't believe that you're here today in the state of Vermont, in this place, to just see God do nothing.
God's doing something. When you take the risk on God, you'll never get up. If you pray your kids are going down, you take the risk on God, guess what? Your kids are going to see what they're going to be warriors for Jesus. I've got faith in them. Of course, I'll be given. As an older generation of people, our kids and our grandkids need to see us live in a risky time that they're taking big, bold steps. Doing it for Jesus, nothing else. Pour out life, listen, pour out life is a risky life. But God didn't call you to anything else. God called you to a risky kind of life. A pour out life is not only risky, but it's also a life of service. This is where you use a life of practice like this. So the son is just on fire. Give me a storm, let me go. And it's like, don't wait. called to a life of service. Mark chapter 10, verses 43 through 45 says this. But among you, it will be different. Whoever wants to be a leader among you must be your servant. And whoever wants to be first among you must be a slave of everyone else. For as even the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve others, and to give his life as a ransom for them. Did anyone catch that? Jesus set the example. Jesus was the greatest. Let me say, Jesus was the greatest. I think we can agree on that. And yet, Jesus did not come to be served, to have everybody bow down to him. But Jesus actually came to serve. In fact, the Greek word diakonos is where we get the Greek word ministers. And what that word means, it means to serve. So you know what that means for each and every one of us, the callers, born again believers? That we're all called to ministry of some sort. But I do not believe the double bind to those that, oh, that pastor's called to ministry. I'm just called to serve. That's a lie. In fact, you know what my job is? My job is to say, A, on three, I've got this guy making mad at me. Yes. Same thing, don't thank you. Yes. I'm going to have to fire on that one. But B, C, to equip the saints for the work of the ministry. I'm trying to this place to be an oasis to God's people who just answer the call and understand the way my purpose for existing is for the poured out life, not a life where everybody pours out for me. I'm so thankful today for the many, many, many people. I know this is the same testimony for you guys, but I get the mic today. I'm so thankful for the many people that pour their lives out for my sake. All the Bible Sunday school teachers that poured themselves out to me, all the people that would meet with me in the evening, every single night of the week, and teach me the word of God when I first became born again Christian. All the people that were served. I remember when I first was going to church, and I thought my guy was just a mystic, and I didn't belong, but the people at the door would welcome me in. And I just remember this one guy. I wish I could remember his name today, but he just, he had a rough past, but he just loved people. I remember coming to the door, and he said, there's no better place for you to be than to be right here. He just said that over every single Sunday. We had Sunday morning, Sunday night, we had Wednesday night, we had Thursday, Sunday, and Friday, Sunday. And he was at the door every single time. And every single time I went to the door, he said, there's no better place for you to be than to be right here. Oh, come on. So there's 90% of people that poured their lives into me. I can't remember their names. When you first become a Christian, like, you're overwhelmed. Overwhelmed with the people that are on time, but you're overwhelmed. But, like, all these new people are pouring themselves into you. And if you remember half of their names or 90% of their names, but you just know that there's so many people that have an impact on your life. And this is what's so important to remember when we pour ourselves out. A life of outpouring. As we pour ourselves out, sometimes you won't get credit when you serve. We want to do our best. We want to help people. We want to train people when they serve God. We want to let everybody know constantly, hey, good job, well done, good and faithful servant. Keep it up. But here's the reality that we're going to miss that sometimes. But just because people don't see it doesn't mean that God doesn't see it. I'll say it again. Just because people don't see it doesn't mean that God doesn't see it. Are you tracking with me today? All right. You're better than I am today, which is kind of hard. Okay. I hope so. Hebrews 6:7. Four days of that, that's why Andrew was helpful. Hebrews 6:7 says this. For God is not unjust. He will not forget your work and the love he demonstrated for his name by serving Christ. God sees it. But he doesn't stop there. This is that's encouraging and some of that teaching, but this is kind of a check. And by continuing to serve him, one of the most wonderful things the pastor in this role is to see people get set on fire for Jesus. I mean, that really get it. and so something stirs up on the inside of them. I don't want to embarrass anybody, but this person is Tamika. I can see that stirring on the inside of Tamika. If you don't know Tamika, she's great. And I just love to see how God just raises people up and sets people on fire. And you can just talk. They're all about you. They're living a poured out life. But one of the most tragic and heartbreaking and frustrating things to happen is we're closed. And by continuing to serve him, we're serving them. If one wants people at one point who live a poured out life, cease to live a poured out life. I've got great counseling advice for you. Ready for it? Stop it. Stop being selfish. Stop living. Again, you guys, you're here today. This is happening out for you. So stop being so selfish. Stop selling. Self-focused. Self-righteous. And allow God to remove self so you can serve others and pour yourself out. And now some of you hear that today, you know, I thought, like, he never affects you. Now you're like, oh, there he is. The person talking to us, he never says anything that's offensive, then, oh, gotcha. To some people, stop pouring themselves out. Because in the process of pouring yourself out, you feel like you've gone broke. You feel like you're broken. You feel like you gave too much. You feel like that you just got into a mess by doing it. You overextended yourself. I'm just telling you, allow the devil to get between your ears and begin to lie to you. Because here's what the Lord wants you to share with you today. Some of those things of pouring yourself out were the most fruitful, fun, exciting times of your life. And now you're reflecting back in a wrong perspective, looking at those things, looking at that time, and having a wrong perspective, wrong perception of that time. And somehow the devil turned that into a negative. But here's the thing we need to know about the pour out life. When you pour out, you'll always be full. Come on. Listen, if you guys stick with me, I might give you a bonus point at the night for the service in there. Alright? So hang in there. When you pour yourself out, you will always be full. It's the day that you stop pouring yourself out that all of a sudden you begin to dry up. Come on now. It's that moment. It's the reason that he puts it in the scriptures. Even his son, and by continuing to serve them, the reason he puts that there is because we get the devil is a liar. I'm not going to say it like a preacher this time. The devil lies to his people to get his people out of the game. And when people get out of the game and no longer pour in, they begin to dry up. They become ineffective. What is the enemy tactic? So listen, if you feel like I'm preaching directly to you, good news.
Because God has helped me see the potential that you have.
Will also be watered himself. Come on. You remember the widow whose son was kidnapped or taken away at the ransom? And he goes to the prophet, and the prophet says, hey, what have you got, you know, for up in your house? That's the rule, by the way. That was kidnapped by the woman. He said, damn it. I think that's what you can. It's amazing how when you pour yourself out, the mask just doesn't light up. And then I put a lot more time in than I could ever imagine. I see that. not some people, right? As you pour in, he's going to pour out. And he's just going to pour it so every single vessel in the house will continue to be full. And then we're going to want to take out of the world. And here's the point for that. I'll say that loud to you because it's a great gospel. If you share this with me, when you pour out, you will pour the extra full. People who pour is not the only people who pour their gifts, their promises, their talents, their seeds of time will never, never be done with us. But it's amazing that in what we're talking, he's saying, with the wisdom, how people who pour out the money to always get more than that. People who know how to pour out, never know how to experience the most important time in their life. I want to get to the point where you pour out, I'm not asking you, look, it's kind of hard for a pastor who's poured it out to come up here and say, look at me, look what I've done. So I know there's poured out people, but I know from my own experience, I've done nothing to say, not things since I did when I gave my life to Christ. That was just something on the inside that needed to just pour it out loud. Now, I'll tell you, I've never gotten this test by pouring it out loud. I've never had it by pouring it out loud. I've never had it by pouring it out loud. I've never gotten drunk by pouring it out loud. But this is my experience in life. When you pour yourself out without holding anything back, God's giving you a life that I can even get in training in if I wanted to. He's given me four amazing children that honestly, I don't know how they're not messed up. It doesn't mean they're fine. And it's so funny because I'm always doing the humble brag or false humility. You don't have a clue. At the end of your life, at the end of anybody's life, you'll never have anybody ever say to you, oh, I wish I would help somebody. I wish I would have poured it all out. You'll never have a kid that look at their father and say, oh, I wish my dad would have poured himself out. I know what some of you are thinking. Some of you have gotten hurt, or maybe felt like you poured yourself out. There's times where it feels that you gave too much or did too much. Here's what I thought they said. You ask them, oh, what about that situation? Well, they poured themselves out for themselves, not for the world. They started out pouring themselves out for the Lord. But they crossed over where they were pouring themselves out to where they began to pour themselves out for themselves. Now that's A. So don't get with your ears getting mad at me because I've been mad at you just for B. We have to be careful when we pour ourselves out that we're not trying to line up to get the glory, or line up to get the credit, or line up to get the Christian, or line up to get the pat on the back. Remember what the scripture said, right? Because they keep on doing it to the end. So again, the second reason is this, and then this was not the way it was, but I don't give it false credit. So if it's wrong, it's not your fault. But here's what I think the Holy Spirit showed me, is that when we is when we pour out all by ourselves, we get self in trouble. That's why it's way better than really asking us to. See, God never designed us to pour ourselves out alone. He called us to the body of Christ. So when you pour out and you're alongside other believers who are pouring themselves out, this is why the local church is so important. But you can't do home church and pour yourself out and think that you can get pulled back up because there's nobody really there to pull you back up. This is why God told us to go. That's why the Bible says do not forsake the assembling of yourselves together as the body of Christ. Because you can't fill yourself up. And the devil has this arrogant spirit you actually give him. That's attention. And you think, oh, I can just throw myself up. I'll just read the Bible. Or my devotions, I'll throw myself up. I'll go, pastor, people like me are the biggest offenders of that reality. Oh, I don't need a shepherd. I don't need a pastor. That's wrong. I need a shepherd and I need a pastor. That's why I have people in my life that speak into my life and trust me and take in on me and watch me. And I'm submitted to them. We need the body so that as I'm pouring out, and they're pouring out. Some of them are pouring out. Getting on the inside of me. Now, just come on. I don't. You thought I was being harsh here for a second. Guess what? Only for a second. And I pour out. You pour out. And what I'm pouring out, you're getting. And what you're pouring out, I'm getting. And together, we're getting filled up again. We're getting filled back up. Listen, the devil does not want us to get filled up. He wants us to walk around empty, broke, busted, and destructive. But I'm here to tell you today. One of the things that I'm so thankful for this church is there's a lot of people who choose to say, you're pouring yourself out into the street. And I'll tell you what, the spirit is that you pour yourself out and you pour out into them. But we need to live a poured out life. I'll be ready for this part. And I have to come out with not enough to prevent the life. Poured out life is a result of friendship with the Holy Spirit. With the Holy Spirit is not saying about knowing the Holy Spirit, but that we are the Holy Spirit. Friendship with the Holy Spirit matters in the same fellowship with the Holy Spirit. You can speak in tongues every day, but I want you to know that you have fellowship with the Holy Spirit, that you're about to have the Holy Spirit, but it does not necessarily mean you have fellowship with the Holy Spirit. You pour out life, friendship with the Holy Spirit, you pour out life. Obedience to take that step of pouring out will actually enable us to be friends with the Holy Spirit. Because that's the purpose of the Holy Spirit. The purpose of the Holy Spirit is to get you to live a poured out life. I love this about the Holy Spirit. You know, the Holy Spirit doesn't make any of us better than anybody else, except for one person. The Holy Spirit helps us be better than ourselves. So that's what you have to know today. The Holy Spirit is not going to make us a better person than that guy, or make me better than you. No, the Holy Spirit is going to make me a better me. And allow me to pour myself out. And the more I pour myself out, I see that God. That's why it's called a poured out offering. That's why it's a gift offering. That's the value of it.